This is Brooke. She's an osprey. She was found in Utah on the ground, starving. She had a very badly injured wing. And she came to us because the wing was so badly injured that she could not be returned to the wild. They're found worldwide. They like to be near waterways, lakes, rivers, seashores. So they're found all over North America, near the coastal areas, and also near inland lakes. And they need to be near water because their main food source is fish. Their hunting is quite unique. They tend to soar over the waterways until they pick a spot where they know there's fish. They'll go down and they'll hover for a few minutes over the prey. And then all of a sudden, they'll just dive down feet first into the water. They usually will go down no more than 3 feet. And these, you can see the talons. And you notice right now that she's got 3 toes forward and 1 back. Well, when they're actually going after prey in the water, what they'll do is the 1 outside toe is an opposable toe, and they'll swing that back, and that helps them to form almost like a little cage around the fish. Their feathers are very, very rough feeling. They're stiff, but they're heavily oiled, and that's what helps them to go down into the water, come out, and remove the water quickly because they can't go back into flight with that fish if they're soaking wet. So then the really interesting part of what they do is they'll get into the air, and that opposable toe they use again. What they do is they'll take the fish and they'll actually position the head so that it's facing in the direction in which they're going. And that gives them better aerodynamics. You'll notice there's a little band that goes across her beak, the top of it. It's a band of skin. What happens is when they dive into the water, in order for them not to have their mouths and lungs fill up with water, that sear, which it's called, comes down and actually covers up those nares. So it keeps it from drinking a lot of water. Their eyes also have a nictitating membrane. It's that third membrane, and that protects their eyes as they go underwater. There may be debris or other things floating in the water, and that helps them to have any eye injuries or to get infections later on. They do migrate. It's a necessity for them. They will migrate as far south as Central and South America, and it usually is about a 5,000-mile trip. These birds were on the endangered species list. They were, unfortunately, part of this whole problem in the 50s and 60s with DDT, where DDT was absorbed by a lot of the fish and other creatures that they eat and subsist on. So what it would do is it would get into their system and it would affect the shells of their eggs. So either the eggs might break under the female as she tried to incubate them, or they just might not hatch at all. So their numbers declined greatly. In 1999, they were actually taken off the endangered species list. It had been about 20 some odd years since the ban, and they seem to be increasing in numbers, and so they're totally off the endangered and threatened species list.